The Moment of Truth. Best songs of 2019. It's that time when we evaluate the year. I mean, we've been already doing it on other videos, but this is the last one. And for me, this is the most fun one. This is the most important one for me because, you know, we listen to songs first and foremost. They are everywhere on the radio, on advertisements, on in the movies, and wherever you go to, like in the grocery stores, like music is playing. And what we have been listening to in 2019 and what gave us enjoyment. Here are my personal picks, 55 songs. And let's start with number 55. We have Costa Rica by Dreamville. It has Jid on it, Bass, Guap Dad 4000, Skimaz the Slum God. So basically, this collaboration, it has a nice Hispanic sort of beat. They rap incredibly well on it. There's high energy. It's basically a really cool song. I really liked it. Track 54, we have I Can't Get Enough. Benny Blanco, Tiny, Selena Gomez, and J Balvin, another sort of Latino-inspired collaboration, but I had fun. Basically, let's move faster because there are a lot of songs. I will just name them all. Okay, here we go. Number 53, you have STFU by Rina Sawayama. Track 52, we have Gone by Charlie XCX and Christine and the Queens. 51, we have Nice to Meet You by Niall Horan. Track 50, we have Baraka by Garmiani. Track 49, we have Focus by Bazzi featuring 21 Savage. Track 48, we have Be Honest by Georgia Smith featuring Burna Boy. By the way, I forgot to mention, I am only including one song per artist, or maximum if there are two appearances by the same artist, he's the feature. It's not his own standalone song if he's appearing the second time. But yeah, maximum two appearances. So I just wanted to have more representation on the songs. 47, we have SOS featuring Aloy Black by Avicii. At 46, we have Low Key by Nicki. At 45, we have Out for Blood by Sum 41. At 44, we have 365 by Zedd and Katy Perry. At 43, we have Help Me Stranger by The Rock on Tears. At 42, we have Blow by Ed Sheeran, Chris Stapleton, and Bruno Mars. As you can see already, we have like four songs that are rock inspired or straight up rock songs. I've been listening to rock this year more than I've been in the past, so my music tastes are expanding, I guess. At 41, we have Wow by Post Malone. At 40, we have Money in the Grave by Drake, featuring Rick Ross, 40, OVO. At 39, we have Frontal Lobe Music by Daniel Caesar, featuring Pharrell Williams. At 38, we have Middle Child by J. Cole. At 37, we have Under the Graveyard by Ozzy Osbourne. At 36, we have Lips Don't Lie by Ali Brooke, featuring A Boogie with a Hoodie. At 35, we have Make It Better by Anderson .Paak, featuring Smokey Robinson. At 34, we have La Romana by Bad Bunny, featuring El Alfa. At 33, we have Don't Call Me Angel by Ariana Grande, Miley Cyrus, and Lana Del Rey, Charlie's Angels soundtrack. At 32, we have Fado by Milky Chance. At 31, we have Loco Contigo by DJ Snake, J Balvin, and Tyga. At 30, we have Your Song by Taron Egerton. That's the soundtrack from Rocketman. Originally, this song was performed by Elton John back in the 70s. At 29, we have Father of All by Green Day. At 28, we have Mile High featuring Travis Scott and Metro Boomin by James Blake. At 27, we have Lights Up by Harry Styles. At 26, we have Jumped Out of a Window by Young Thug. At 25, we have Nothing Great About Britain by Slow Tie. At 24, we have Jesus Is the One. I Got Depression. I actually did a video on it, just like a sort of fun cover. It was cool. At 23, we have Squidward Knows by Cupcake. At 22, we have Dirty Laundry by Danny Brown. At 21, we have Highest in the Room by Travis Scott. I should have ranked a little bit higher, I think, because I listened to it much more than putting it on 21st. Like, when it comes to, you know, repeat value, like Apple Music showed me that actually, like, in the highest in the room already, top 10, because I listen to it a lot. At 20, we have Crop Circles by John Belin. At 19, we have Palm Leaf by Freddie Gibbs and Madlib, featuring Pusha T and Killer Mike. At 18, we have Vacant by Rich Brian. At 17, we have La 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 by Y2K and Baby No Money. At number 16, we have Follow God by Kanye West. At number 15, we have Same Old Story by Skepta. At number 14, we have Yo Por Ti, Tu Por Mi by Rosalía and Ozuna. At track 13, we have Take Me Down Easy by James Henry Jr. This song appeared on BoJack Horseman Season 6 from Netflix. I really dig the song, and it's just something special. It's a singer-songwriter sort of song. It gave me Ed Sheeran vibes. At track 12, we have Truth Hurts by Lizzo. At track 11, we have Bad Guy by Billie Eilish. And then now, here we go, top 10. Top 10 for me was at number 10, Drip Too Hard by Lil Baby and Gunna. At number 9, we have A Lot by 21 Savage. At number 8, we have Bop by DaBaby. At number 7, we have 7 Rings by Ariana Grande. At number 6, we have Zulu Screams by Goldlink featuring Malik Berry. At number 5, we have Sucker by Jonas Brothers. At number 4, we have Earthquake by Tyler, the Creator. At number 3, we have Heartless by The Weeknd. At number 2, we have Boy Bye by Brockhampton. And number 1, actually, between the winner and the second song, Boy Bye, there's almost twice difference when it comes to listening. I listened to Boy Bye like around 60 listens, and Old Town Road I gave 120 listens to that song. I really listened to it a lot. Oh, I already said the name. Yeah, it's Old Town Road by Lil Nas X featuring Billy Ray Cyrus, that remix, not the original one, but the actual remix with Billy Ray Cyrus. You know, I listened to it 120 times, and plus if you count how much I listened to the original song and plus the other remixes, I feel like it's, I would say, around 200 times. Like, I listened to this song this year. It's really my favorite song of the year because how catchy it was and how fun it was. It gave me really great vibes. It was like listening to Happy by Pharrell Williams again back in 2014 when you put Happy made your life a little bit more happier and you know, just more positive and bright, and Old Town Road was that track for me. I really enjoyed it, and it was a good year. Actually, it was a good year. I was kind of complaining about this year a little bit back in the day, back in the beginning, but it picked later, like in summer, and kept going strong until the end of the year. Was a good year. I'm liking the songs I choose. I spent a lot of time actually picking the songs, and I was like, even like before doing this video, just like before turning on the camera, I wanted to just maybe edit something out, like add another song, and like, hey, like this, oh, this song should have been here. But like, I limited myself to only 55 songs. It was like 50 in the beginning. I wanted to just stick with 50, but then I a little bit extended because I can't left out some of these songs. So it ended up being 55 songs. This was my picks, but what about you? What were your favorite songs of 2019? Or just favorite song? Yeah, just give me one in the comments below. I wanna see your taste as well. Let's share the love for music. And thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for being with me throughout this year. 2020 is gonna be lit, and I also am going to London in the beginning of January in 2020, so maybe there will be some videos from there. We'll see about that, but I'm actually excited to grab a camera and just film something around. I know there it will be a lot of rain, but I hope that it's still gonna be fun, and I will be able to make some cool videos with that footage. We'll see how it goes. But so exciting times, at least for me, is coming. Hope it will be great for you as well in 2020. Let's hope for an even better year. More love, more fun, more sex, more everything. Like, let's keep it real. Let's more money, of course. Money, that's what allows us to do things. So yeah, enjoy your rest of the 2 days left or whatever. Now, but enjoy the rest of 2019 and 2020. We are coming. Thank you so much for watching.